Now on WRDE Coast TV.
More pot restrictions along our coast. Find out which two coastal communities said no to marijuana this afternoon.
The signs read "Justice for Gavin Knupp," but that's not what happened today. The shocking turn of events at Worcester County Courthouse.
And now that the frontal boundary has passed to our south, we are in store for a very interesting weekend with the kind of sunshine I believe you can get behind, but the UV index is also going up.
Guns at schools, limiting guns at the polls. New legislation officially signed into law today. It's also our Coast TV poll question. And post office theft, how much police say was stolen by a Smyrna mail worker?
From the beaches to the bay, coverage you can count on. WRDE Coast TV, your local news at 11 starts right now.
Just saying no to drugs, at least when it comes to legal marijuana operations. Good evening, I'm Charlie Sakaitis. Mallory Metzner has the night off. Welcome to our news at 11. We begin tonight with more coastal towns finalizing their marijuana restrictions. Two more towns joined the movement in banning the sale of pot today. And some say this is the right move for the vacation towns. But as Coast TV News reporter Charles Reinert shows us, some say that the decision is a little short-sighted.
If you wanted to open a marijuana store in Rehoboth Beach or Bethany Beach, you are now out of luck. Both towns decided to put more restrictions on marijuana, with both towns saying no to marijuana businesses. Rehoboth Beach Mayor Stan Mills says on top of wanting to keep the nation's summer capital family-friendly, there was no incentive to allow marijuana in the city.
The state is the only one allowed to impose taxes. The city would gain no revenue other than through business license, perhaps. But the overwhelming support from the commissioners was to place restrictions on marijuana, specifically by prohibiting.
Rehoboth Beach commissioners also banned marijuana from being smoked in public. Zoe Patchell with the Delaware Cannabis Advocacy Network says she believes it's a short-sighted decision.
It doesn't take into account the historic examples that we've had with alcohol prohibition. And when you ban something that's in such a high demand, it just forces it back to the illicit market, which only puts the consumer and communities at risk.
But Steve Murain says marijuana doesn't belong on the Delaware coast.
I've been to Bethany Beach, I've been to Ocean City, I've been up to Lewis, and all of them, they're very, very nice areas, and I'd just like to see it stay that way.
So while the drug may now be legal in the first state, finding a legal place to buy it along the coast is becoming a pipe dream.
Some towns like Dewey Beach and Ocean City have already implemented similar bans on marijuana, but other communities such as Lewis and Fenwick Island are expected to continue similar discussions, but nothing has passed in those communities just yet. I'm Charles Reiner in Bethany Beach, Coast TV News.
While our coastal towns continue to figure out how they want to deal with marijuana, the view on alcohol nationwide seems to be changing. A recent Gallup poll shows that more people believe alcohol is harmful. 39% of Americans said that 1 to 2 drinks per day is bad for your health. That's an 11% increase from just 2018, and it's a record high number. The survey also showed that the younger you are, the more likely you are to believe booze is bad. Interestingly, Americans don't seem that worried about pot, though only 23% considered marijuana very harmful. In a shocking twist today, the current charges against the man accused of hitting and killing Worcester County teenager Gavin Knupp were dismissed on procedural grounds. The judge in the case against Tyler Mayu said that the case should be tried in district court, not circuit court, where it was today. Knupp was the victim of a hit and run on Gray's Corner Road in Berlin, near where a memorial stands for him. That was July of 2022. Knupp was just 14 years old. Charges were not filed until May of this year. The longevity of the case drawing outrage and widespread community support seen in signs in town. It is important to note that all 17 charges against Mayu were traffic related. The Worcester County State's Attorney says that this case is far from over. Prosecutors have already filed an appeal against the judge's dismissal, wanting to keep the case in circuit court. While waiting appeal, prosecutors say the case remains pending A Canup family lawyer declined to comment further past the proceedings, and now the family waits to see if this case will stay in circuit court or must be tried in district court. Let's go ahead and take a live look outside right now. The Rehoboth Beach Boardwalk right there, and this is our Boardwalk Plaza Hotel cam. Our First Alert Chief Meteorologist Paul Williams standing by with a look at your weather.
We are clear right now as far as the skyline is concerned, and we're clear as far as our live radar is concerned. We stay clear for the entire peninsula, not even concerned much about wind. Your dog walking forecast, listen, you're going to stay clear for us as we go throughout a good portion of tomorrow with temperatures in the 70s. And our face of grace practice and sun safety, well, the UV index is going to be at a 9, so the burn time is going to be at about a 20. Now, one story that's been gaining a lot of headline is actually Hurricane Hillary that's off of the West Coast. It's a Category 4 hurricane. It's moving to the north-northwest at 13 miles per hour. Sustained winds at 30 miles per hour. Wind gusts up to 160. You can see the hurricane warnings that have already been issued along the path. It's a Category 4, and it's going to track its way all the way up into San Diego as well as Los Angeles, something that has never happened before. And we're getting a whole lot of headlines as far as what's happening throughout portions of Canada with the fires. Now listen, if Hillary makes landfall in California as a tropical storm, which we expect it to do, it'll be the first time in 84 years. Meanwhile, as Patrick Cornell reports, Canada is in the middle of the most severe fire season on record.
Hurricane Hillary looming towards Mexico's Baja California Peninsula as a powerful Category 4 storm, potentially dumping a year's worth of rain on the southwestern United States.
The rain will be very heavy with this system.
Its track churning about 400 miles south of Cabo San Lucas, Mexico as of Friday, with sustained winds of 145 miles per hour. West Coast officials making urgent preparations as the first ever tropical storm watch is issued for California.
We'll be in the lowest level of activation, ready. But as it escalates, we'll start bringing in the other individuals to staff the EOC.
Nearly 3,000 miles away, another urgent situation is unfolding as hundreds of wildfires burn in Canada's British Columbia and Northwest Territories.
These fires are very active and very unpredictable.
In Northwest Territories' capital city of Yellowknife, those fleeing the more than 200 active wildfires are forced to navigate dangerous road conditions or endure long wait times for emergency flights.
Military aircraft are scheduled for today. We'll continue to focus on helping the most vulnerable.
Canadian Armed Forces, along with first responders, are helping to evacuate more than 20,000 residents of Yellowknife and surrounding territories. Half of the population has now been displaced.
They're dousing hotspots to prevent further outbreaks. And very importantly, they have been working with local officials to construct fire breaks in and around the western region of Yellowknife and Etah to stop the spread and to protect critical infrastructure, homes, and that in community.
I'm Patrick Cornell reporting.
Two gun control bills were signed in Delaware today, drawing some controversy. These bills will keep anybody that is not a constable or a person of law enforcement from bringing a gun on school property or a polling place outside of their car. Supporters say that the new laws create safer spaces for students and for voters. However, Jeff Haig with the Delaware State Sportsman Association believes this was never a problem for the state to begin with.
People with firearms in schools are not a problem. The statute's been on the books for years about whether you can or cannot carry a firearm in the school zone. Didn't need to be changed. It was never an issue.
The next goal for gun control advocates would be a permit to purchase law, and they'd like to see that signed by next year. This brings us to our Coast TV poll. We want to know who you think should be allowed to have guns at schools or polling places. Let's take a look at the updated results from earlier this evening. Here's what they say at the moment. And so far, the runaway leader, just law enforcement. That's at 78%. But again, this is a little bit controversial. So if you want to vote, you can do that on WRDE.com or our mobile app. We're going to show you updated results later on in this newscast.
I'm Madeline Overturf. Here's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. Smyrna police have arrested two men, one who worked at the post office, for stealing. Police say the men stole checks, credit cards, and even debit cards from letters, sometimes altering and cashing the checks. They are facing multiple charges. Plan ahead, Worcester County drivers. St. Luke's Road from Route 12 to Greenbrier Swamp Road will be closed for 2 days. This starts on Monday. The Berlin Fire Company has a nearly $400,000 grant. Senator Chris Van Hollen announced the money. The new funds will be used to purchase new equipment. That's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. I'm Madeline Overturf.
Dewey Beach commissioners voted today to change the daily curfew for kids and teenagers. Before the vote, the curfew for these groups was 11 p.m. Sunday through Thursday, while Friday and Saturdays was 12 a.m. Now that curfew is just 11 p.m. That's 7 days a week. Now, one problem brought up by commissioners was stopping teenagers who aren't actually doing anything wrong.
There's good teenagers and there's some bad teenagers too. I mean, we don't really care about the good teenagers. I don't think our pretty sure chief is in here and instructing the officers to arrest good people. No, that's not the idea.
The council referenced other surrounding coastal towns' restrictive curfews as precedent for the change. Two kayakers that were stranded in the Indian River are safe. The Coast Guard says it rescued the two kayakers from Burton Island after they were beset by weather on Thursday. The agency says that it commends them for wearing their life jackets, and fortunately no injuries were reported. We've got more news still to come this evening. Coming up, campground fires that was destroyed in Somerset County.
And right here in Sussex County, we're looking for Saturday to start off with a great deal of sunshine. But look at this. Temperatures in the 50s, a nice cool start to your weekend.
From free family fun to events that offer camaraderie to those who have served, I'm Mallory Metzner. Coming up, I'll show you all the cool things to do this weekend.
You're the science guy.
That's Bill Nye. I'm actually the behavioral science guy.
Are you familiar with predictable irrationality?
Paradoxical persuasion.
Retrospective framing.
Attentional blindness.
Bereavement sex.
That's a thing.
Nothing irrational about that.
Understanding human nature can be a superpower, which is why the FBI ends up calling me.
Did you really help the Rams win the Super Bowl?
Well, that was a risky experiment, but it worked out for them.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Right now, get 2.9% financing for 60 months, plus up to $1,000 on select Ford SUVs.
A Somerset County campground store caught fire on Thursday afternoon. And just take a look at the damage in the photos we have for you. According to the Maryland State Fire Marshal, it happened at the Lake Somerset Family Campground. Investigators say that the fire started in the attic, likely because of an accidental electrical failure. The fire marshal estimates about $200,000 in damage between the building and all the things inside. The good news is no injuries reported. And the Maryland State Fire Marshal is investigating another fire from Thursday afternoon, this one in Wicomico County. Investigators say this garage fire on Laws Road in Parsonsburg may have been caused by heat from grass clippings under the mower deck of a tractor recently. Look, it took out that whole thing. The fire marshal says another outbuilding nearby also suffered some damage from the fire.
Sweltering heat like that can spark fires. Well, it's still a possibility, even though we're going to be dropping into the 80s. Please remember that when you're in a capsule place like a car or a shed, that the temperature can go up exponentially very quickly. Although we are expecting a cooler feeling weekend. Here's a look at Ocean City, courtesy of our Royal Plus camera. 75 degrees and the winds right now moving out of the north, which helps in our comfort level, to be quite honest. The live radar is indicating, hey, we're staying pretty clear right now. We do have a small craft advisory that's active along the Chesapeake Bay area. So we're basically watching out for about 25, 30 mile per hour wind gusts. But aside from that, all the action that's connected to the frontal boundary passing through, it's actually well to our south down towards Norfolk. So it's no longer a concern in our neighborhood. Here's a look at the temps. We're at 74 in Rehoboth Beach, 75 Bethany Beach. But look at this. We're already going to 67 in Redding, 65 in Greenwood. And we're going to tumble even more than that. Wait till I show you. But let me set the stage on just how cool it's feeling even right now. The dew point temperatures, a measurement of the moisture content in the atmosphere, they've been at 70s and 60s and upper 60s and all that crazy stuff when we've been dealing with this severe weather. Now we're at 57 with the dew point temperature and 55 with Milford and 58 in Georgetown. a lot cooler because the air just isn't as thick to walk through, so it feels a lot better. Take a look at the muggy meter. You see, for Saturday, we're down here below comfy. That's some good stuff. Now, Sunday, we start escalating, and Monday, we go all the way up back to very humid. There's a big reason for that, because a lot of moisture is going to kick back in. But while the winds are coming out of the northwest, we stay cool and comfortable, particularly clear. But look at where we end up, 55 in Milford, 57 in Georgetown and Milton, 57 in Millsboro, and 57 in Selbyville. That's the start of Saturday. Dare I say, a chill in the air Saturday morning? Let's keep that between you and me. All right. Saturday afternoon, we are well into the 70s, upper 70s inland, mid to low 70s along the coast. Sunday, different story now. Sunday, we start off in the 60s. So, you know, the deck is stacked against us having another cool day. And the winds are pushing out of the south. So we'll have the temperatures well into the 80s. Won't be quite as cool on Sunday, but it will be just as sunny. Sneezecast, weeds and grass, those are going to be the ones that are going to cause your nose to run a little bit more. But as you take a look at the beach forecast, Saturday and Sunday, we're looking at sunshine and Assateague, but no rain. A few clouds on Monday in South Bethany and 89 degrees. So you see that heat kicking in on Monday there as well. And finally, 90 degrees the expected high in Cape Henlopen, but 2 days of sunshine, they're going to be comfortable Saturday and Sunday. Here's a look at your exclusive 7-day forecast here, courtesy of Paul Davis. 20% chance of rain on Tuesday, but it's after a 95-degree day on Monday.
Thank you, Paul. Going to be hot on Monday. A reminder, you can hear Coast TV news and weather updates throughout the day on our family of radio stations, Coast Country 103.9 and 106.3 FM, on 93.5 The Beach and on Big 107.7. The weekend is for spending time with family and friends. I like spending it with you guys at home. Lots of local events aim to bring people together who have similar interests or experiences. Coast TV's Mallory Metzner shows us the cool things to do.
People who may have similar interests or experiences can gather at different events around Delmarva this weekend. The Wicomico County Fair is back at Winter Place Park in Salisbury. You can expect to see the Maryland High School Rodeo, livestock shows, a petting farm, fair queen pageant, axe throwing, and more. The Beachcombers Corvette Club of Southern Delaware is having its annual charity car show on Saturday. Organizers say all years, makes, and models are welcome. It takes place at First State Chevrolet on Route 113 from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. A dedication ceremony to recognize veterans and military members with ties to Millsboro takes place Saturday. A Hometown Heroes banner dedication is taking place in Cupola Park at 10 a.m. A group that offers camaraderie, humor, and support to veterans has an event in Rehoboth Beach on Saturday. A Silkies Hike for the Delaware chapter of the Irreverent Warriors starts at Epworth United Methodist Church at 9 a.m. and goes to the Rehoboth Beach Bandstand and back. The Boy Scouts of America Delmarva Council is hosting a Sussex District alumni gathering. Organizers say it's made for former scouts, current scouts, their families, and anyone interested in learning more about scouting. The event will be held at noon on Saturday at the Henson Scout Reservation in Dorchester County. The Pocomoke Boat Docking Challenge is back for its 10th year. The gates open at noon, but 2 p.m. is when captains will try to tame the Pocomoke River Tide on Saturday. Ellendale is hosting a family fun day also Saturday from 10 to 2 at Town Hall and the surrounding park areas. There will be a DJ, kids zone, vendors, and more. We have links to event schedules, tickets, and even required gear on our website under the Cool Things to Do tab.
Brought to you by North Bay Marina, where boaters have the most fun.
Arrive in style with the new Mercedes-Benz SUV from IG Burton Mercedes-Benz in Melford. Right now, you can have the style and versatility of the new GLC for just $669 per month. IG Burton Mercedes-Benz in Melford. Shop us now online at igburtonmb.com.
Come celebrate the grand opening of the Furniture and More outlet in Milford, Delaware. Save up to 70% off all your favorite name brands. Door busters like this sofa love seat or sectional, only $7.99. Recliners starting at only $2.79. Adirondack chairs, only $1.79. Hurry to the grand opening of the Furniture and More outlet in Milford. From the city to the shore, we always save you more. Oh, one more thing. Ask about getting your purchase for free.
Hi, I'm Joel Wharton, Sussex County farmer. Don't wait until after harvest to plant your cover crops.
Consider broadcasting or interseeding cover crops into your standing cash crop. Early establishment provides more growth potential and more soil armor over winter. It also saves time because after harvest, the cover crop is already growing and protecting the soil, cycling nutrients, and preventing erosion. To learn more about the benefits and ways to establish cover crops early, contact the Sussex Conservation District because every acre counts.
100.9% classic country.
And that's close enough to perfect for me.
I still got time, I got to get away.
Tune to 100.9% classic country or download the app to listen anywhere.
We're Coast Country, and we're Delmarva proud.
Arrive in style with a new Mercedes-Benz SUV from IG Burton Mercedes-Benz in Melford. Right now, you can have the style and versatility of the new GLC for just $669 per month. IG Burton Mercedes-Benz in Melford. Shop us now online at igburtonmb.com.
Teachers needed here in the first state. According to the Delaware State Education Association, there are 400 vacant teacher spots across Delaware. Del Tech Community College has a new bachelor's program to combat the shortage. Participants graduate with a full year of teaching under their belt, and Del Tech says that it makes a big difference.
As an educator myself, I think that education is an avenue to help individuals to be successful in life. And I think there's a lot of meaning behind that work.
The program is available at multiple Del Tech campuses. That includes the one in Georgetown. A Florida Proud Boy convicted on 7 counts stemming from his actions during the January 6th riot has gone missing. Christopher Worrell was scheduled to be sentenced on Friday in Washington, D.C. federal court. That's now been indefinitely postponed. The FBI has now issued a warrant, or a wanted poster rather, for Worrell, as seen a few seconds ago. Prosecutors are seeking a 14-year prison sentence after Worrell refused to take responsibility or show remorse for his crimes. He also lied under oath and now the authorities are in pursuit. Former President Donald Trump is expected to skip the first Republican presidential debate on Wednesday and instead do a sit-down interview with former Fox News host Tucker Carlson. That's according to multiple sources familiar with his plans. It's not clear exactly when the interview will take place, but it's expected to air around the same time as the debate. Trump's advisors say, however, that he could still change his mind at the last minute and decide to attend the debate after all.
Delmarva Sports Network from the Wawa Studios.
What's going on, sports fans? Football season is here, and tonight was the first scrimmage for two Henlopen South teams. The Seaford Blue Jays are a new-look team as they went against Del Mar tonight. First-year head coach, varsity starting quarterback as well, his first time under the helm as a starter. There are different faces for sure, but the culture remains the same. Work hard and bring in athletes who are all in. Quarterback James McNeil talks about this experience under the helm, and first-year head coach Austin Perry gives us an insight on how this process has been.
I've been a backup for my good friend Kareem for a few years, so watching him and playing on the defensive side of the ball before coming to quarterback has been beneficial for the watching Kareem and him being, when I did go in at quarterback, him being a positive influence. So coming out here, I'm not gonna say it was easy, but knowing I had him in my corner made it better.
Smoother transition than I anticipated. Coach Quillen pretty much prepared me for it the last 2 years. I knew this opportunity was gonna come, and being with these kids the past 2 years also, it's just a smooth transition. They already knew my style. They knew what to expect from me, and just like I knew what to expect from them and how to put them in the best situation.
That's all for sports. Have a great night, everybody.
Denrek says bat pups. I'm going to say that one more time, bat pups. They're now out and flying, so don't be scared when you see them. They say you may see the baby bats in unusual places like on walls, porches, or just hanging a little low. The department says that the bats will be on their way soon. They say the best thing to do if you see them is just leave them alone. Still to come, grab-and-go lunches, why one local woman is feeding kids in need during the summer, and reach out Rehoboth, the beach town that's about to release a new website for locals and visitors alike.
Now at Hardee's, two hand-breaded chicken tender wraps are only $5. Choose one of five flavors for endless combinations, including new Nashville Hot. Two wraps, just $5. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
Summer won't last forever, but with a great selection of vehicles during Toyota's national sales event, there's still time to capture new memories.
Hey, how are you?
With friends and family. Before it all flies by.
Get 3.99% APR on a Tacoma, or go a point lower on a 4x2. Or pick a 2023 Tundra or 4Runner, two of the top 10 cars with best resale value.
Come in today.
Toyota, let's go places.
Rural communities are on the front lines of a changing climate. Farmers can implement climate-smart practices that improve soil health, nutrient management, and energy efficiency. These practices improve our profitability, resiliency, and help to open new markets.
We know voluntary conservation works and are committed to working with farmers and forest landowners to leverage resources to increase climate resiliency through conservation practices. To learn more about climate-smart practices, scan this QR code to find your local USDA service center.
Welcome the new season with a deep cleaning by Stanley Steamer. Our certified technicians will renew your carpets, air ducts, upholstery, tile floors, and more, clearing away the dust and debris. We clean using powerful proprietary equipment and family-safe cleaning solutions to leave your space looking and feeling fresh. Call or go online to schedule your professional cleaning with Stanley Steamer today.
Ready for an unforgettable driving experience at Gateway Subaru. Discover the rugged elegance of the Subaru Outback with its symmetrical all-wheel drive that ensures you'll conquer any terrain with confidence. Or get ready to elevate your drive with the all-new, redesigned 2024 Subaru Crosstrek with its sleek design, advanced technology, and enhanced performance. Right now, you can custom order the all-new Crosstrek at Gateway Subaru. Embrace the thrill of driving and embark on your next adventure. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Gateway Subaru. Higher standards.
Make dinner good tonight with Hardee's new chicken tender platters. Crunchy, juicy tenders all dipped in buttermilk and hand-breaded with a thick slice of garlicky Texas toast, seasoned crinkle fries, slaw, and choice of sauce. Hardee's, goodness in the making.
The Rehoboth Beach community will soon be connected on another level. On Friday, August 25th, the city is launching a digital engagement platform where visitors can learn about projects, ask questions, and share feedback about Rehoboth Beach. City Manager Lawrence Christian says that he believes that Reach Out Rehoboth will lead to more collaborative decision-making. A link for the platform will be posted on the city's webpage on its home site. Making a difference can be as simple as making a lunch. And when one Lincoln woman saw a need in her community, that is exactly what she did. She made lunches, thousands of them, to help feed the kids in her area. Coast TV News reporter Carmen Holland shows us how, if you look close enough, you'll see the people around you being the change that they want to see in the world.
Cereal, apples, grilled cheese, and an assembly line with one purpose.
In every community, there's a need for a food program for the kids during the summertime.
Stephanie Dukes has been feeding kids every summer for 30 years. Dukes runs the summer feeding program, and with a little help from her family, the group distributes bags of breakfast and lunch to kids all across Sussex County.
I feed 340 kids a day.
From Ellendale to Lincoln, kids and families in need just have to listen for the beep. In the last 20 years, the USDA has become a partner, donating food to help pack the vans going to different neighborhoods. And it's not just the stops on the route, but friendships they've gained over the years. Stephanie says the need for this program might surprise some.
We're helping a child. We're giving them a nutritious food. We're giving them, you know, something to look forward to, because if a child go hungry, you know, that's really something. And then here in America, we never thought kids would go without, but they do.
As the saying goes, it takes a village. Stephanie, alongside her sister, nephews, nieces, and family, spend their time giving back.
Fantastic, honey. Shaking the bushes. Find the keys.
For her, it's about the legacy of her own family and the impact she wants to leave behind.
Our family have always taken care of children. Go out and serve with compassion. Serve with a smile on your face.
The summer feeding program will be over in about 2 weeks once school starts back up, but they could always use volunteers. If you're interested in volunteering, you can reach out to the Family Outreach Center from our website. In Lincoln, I'm Carmen Holland, Coast TV News.
What a great program. Coming up, Firefightin' 5K, where you can run for the Rehoboth Beach Volunteer Fire Company this weekend. Stay tuned on WRDE News at 6.
Download the DSN app today, driven by Preston Automotive Group.
Johnny Janosik is your one-stop mattress superstore. Shop now and save up to $600 on select adjustable bases, plus 0% APR financing for 60 months. Shop the Labor Day mattress sale at Johnny Janosik's Mattress World.
Home IQ, the new smart home technology by Schell Brothers, gives you control of your entire home, even when you're not there. Your smart home command center allows full control of your home from one monitor. Smart switches in every bedroom let you set alarms, check the weather, and control your lights using just your voice. With mobile access to your video doorbell, keyless entry, and garage door, your home has never been more secure. Introducing Home IQ by Schell Brothers, now included with every new Schell Brothers home.
The American black duck is an iconic species well known throughout the Delmarva Peninsula. Although the population is currently stable, they're well below their population goals and they're considered a species of concern. The USDA Natural Resources Conservation Service looks to increase and restore black duck habitat throughout the Delmarva Peninsula.
I utilize the Working Lands for Wildlife program to help transform a low-lying wet area into waterfowl habitat.
To learn more about the Working Lands for Wildlife program, contact your local USDA service center.
BMW iX is electricity in its ultimate form, an elegant trailblazer that's equal parts power and intelligence. With impeccable interior details, a range of up to 324 miles, and a panoramic moonroof for every shade of luxury. It's 100% electric and 100% BMW. BMW, the ultimate electric driving machine.
Go electric, go BMW at IG Burton BMW in Melford.
Coastal Delmarva has so much going on.
Food, friends, fun, and more.
Why don't I just show you?
Coast Life, weekdays at 4 on WRDE Coast TV.
Says live in Texas.
100.9% classic country plays real country the way you remember it.
Johnny Janosik is your one-stop mattress superstore. Shop now and save up to $600 on select adjustable bases, plus 0% APR financing for 60 months. Shop the Labor Day mattress sale at Johnny Janosik's Mattress World.
Officers will take to the streets of Rehoboth Beach on Sunday this weekend for the Firefightin' 5K. It's the Rehoboth Beach Volunteer Fire Company's ninth annual 5K run walk. The race starts at 8 a.m. at the fire station on Rehoboth Avenue, and we will have a link to sign up on our website under the Cool Things to Do tab.
Our umbrella giveaway winner for tonight is actually Rich Stern of Milton. Congratulations, courtesy of Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling. And be sure you have to go to online to our website so that you can actually enter for that in case you didn't know. By the way, here's a look at our exclusive Coast TV 10-day forecast. Saturday, we're looking for sunshine, but not just any kind of sunshine, a nice, cool, comfortable sunshine, because the dew point temperature is going to be lower, so it's going to be cool, not muggy. Sunday's going to be sunny, but Sunday's going to be muggy. Monday's going to be extremely muggy, and it's going to feel like, well, 95 for the high, but it's going to feel like 107, possibly even 110 for Monday afternoon, which, if my friends love me, they won't send me out in the sun too long. But Tuesday, we'll drop by 15 degrees and have cloudy skies. And then we'll stay in the lower 80s going into all of next week. And then next weekend, we may run into a few showers here or there. Charlie?
Feeling like 105 to 110. That is hot. Thanks for joining us here for Coast TV News at 11. For more news and local weather, download our Coast TV News app. The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, that's coming up next. We're going to see you tomorrow for Coast TV News at 6. Have a great night.